have friends.
Are you friends?
You're dying.
I'm invisible. No one knows who I am, but everyone knows who you are. I'm cool because I do this. I'm better than you. You're a loser. I can walk behind a computer screen and no one will ever know who I am. I am anonymous. And I can hide behind a mask.
Suicide awareness. To me, suicide awareness is kids reaching out to other kids saying it's going to be okay, because it's a lot easier for your own peers to demonstrate things that you might have gone through, and just to show them that, listen, we all have our own problems, it's fine, but you're going to get through it. I definitely think it reaches out to kids, because especially since we all know each other, all the kids performing, you know, the kids in the audience, it's different, it's on a different level of comfort. It's like, I know this person and they're telling me that it's going to be okay.
Suicide awareness is a really good opportunity, because I don't know a lot of schools that do something like this. I know a lot of schools, like, their suicide prevention program is a pamphlet or an assembly for a half hour of somebody just speaking at them. So I think showing them in an artistic way, a creative way, and a way that they can enjoy, so it's not just a boring assembly or a piece of paper, is different from other schools. So we really get to reach out to them, and we have fun doing it. Like, it's a lot of depressing stuff, but we get to know a lot about ourselves and a lot about the audience as well. For the past 3 years, we've been doing the scenes that were originally in Suicide Awareness from the first time. So this year, Mr. Prada decided, hey, let's write all new scenes. And we kept a few of them, like the Red and Jane, but 99% of the scenes that are in the one this year and probably the coming years are going to be new scenes that are written, just to keep it with the times. Like, now we have cyberbullying, which wasn't really present 15 years ago. So now when we have cyberbullying scenes, it makes more sense to have it here.
I've been involved for 4 years, and I absolutely think it helps. I think that kids are the front line, and they need to be aware of what the signs are.
This is my first year at the school, but yeah, I think it's a definite positive for the ninth graders, but for the whole school in general, just to have this program, the awareness to be out there.
It brings to light that this is an issue, and that they can actually help by being aware of what the signs are, and that's really the goal here, is to have all the kids be aware of what the signs of depression or suicide, or even, you know, what to do when they're under an immense amount of stress or they're depressed, you know, because at this stage of life, kids talk to each other more so than they do talk to the adults in their world, so that's why we think it's so important.
You know, it's funny, the very first scene that I saw, a fellow said, he said he had an idea to do a scene, an improv to music, a pantomime to music, to a real heavy song, The Red, by a band called Chevelle. And he went home and he brought the scene back and he acted it out. And I thought, this is too brutal, this is too violent, how are we going to do this? And he, you know, I mean, people were upset watching the scene. And then the vice principal at the time and Dr. Grinnelli, they watched the scene. They said, "Well, that's okay." I said, "Oh my God!" I mean, I was staggered by it. But I think the reactions have been very positive.
But you don't have to be teased to be tortured, and you don't have to be hurt to feel pain. I'm lucky. I realized there were people I could talk to. I can't believe I almost missed this. Because when I look around now, I know nothing is perfect, but it's still beautiful.